Please bow your heads and let us pray. Dear Jesus, please show me how to spend this day sharing your love in every way. Help me to be kind to everyone, to play and love and have lots of fun, shining your light and giving your grace, sharing your joy with a smile on my face. Angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits me here. Ever this day, be at my side, to light and guard, to rule and guide. Amen.
For Ping Pong on YouTube.
Eat food, you chew it into smaller pieces and swallow it. It mixes with saliva, which comes from the salivary glands. The food then goes down the esophagus and into the stomach. When the food leaves the stomach, it begins its journey into the small intestine. Digestive juices from the liver, gallbladder, and pancreas help break down the food so your body can use it as energy. After winding its way through the small intestine, food enters the large intestine, where water and minerals are pulled out of it. At the end of the large intestine, the food is ready for another journey. End of.
The process is called digestion and is done in the digestive system. The digestive system is a very long tube through which the food travels and is made up of the following parts. The mouth, this is where the digestive journey begins. The teeth both chop and grind up the food we eat. Once it has been made into a ball, it is pushed down the food pipe to the pharynx. The pharynx is a cavity which shares the digestive system with the respiratory system. It is from the pharynx that the food goes to the esophagus. The esophagus is a soft muscular tube that moves food further down to the stomach. The stomach is a widening of the digestive tube. It creates a movement which allows food with a mixture of gastric fluids. Once this process has been done, it then travels to the small intestine. The small intestine is called small because of its width, not its length. It is actually a lot longer than the large intestine, measuring up to 7 meters in length, almost as wide as a football goal from post to post. Well, it is here, in the small intestine, where the food digestion journey ends. Now it is up to fluid processes by two glands, the liver and the pancreas, to finalize the transformation from foods to nutrients. Once the food is converted into nutrients, they then traverse the small intestine's walls and filter into our blood, where they are then made good use of by all of our body cells. But what happens to the food that our body doesn't need? All that, such as fiber, for example, is transferred into the large intestine. The large intestine is a thick tube which accumulates substances which our organism cannot digest, and it is where water from these substances is absorbed. The substances then form fecal matter, or what we call poop, and it comes out of the anus. It sounds a little bit disgusting, but that's how our body works. Anyway, friends, I hope you found the digestive system and digestion as interesting as I did. See you later, and don't forget to subscribe to Happy Learning.